Let's cross over now to Emma and Jason, who are our fashion police for today. We are interested in what the celebs are wearing. We can't get away from it. Who have we seen so far, guys?
We're just taking a look at the red carpet now. That was Patricia Arquette, but all the big guns, they are yet to arrive yet, Sarah. But we have seen Ryan Seacrest. He's turned up. He's looking dashing with a little bit of a beard, as we saw before. Patricia Arquette, though, she is in black and white, and we're going to get to that in a little bit moment about the psychology of dressing to possibly win an Oscar. But this is Juliana Rancic as well. She has tweeted a photo of herself. She is looking gorgeous in Stephen Khalil, an Australian designer, which is great to see. I think we've all got to remember, though, that this is one of the biggest days on the fashion calendar. It's a massive industry, and while we do want to ask the stars, you know, other questions, this is a big moment for the designers such as Stephen Khalil.
Definitely. It puts them on the world stage. I mean, it, you know, gives them so much exposure. I love this dress. It's a little bridal for me, but I don't mind it. It's like she's about to get married, but it's a beautiful dress. You know, she holds herself very well, but definitely a bit bridal for me.
He is a bridal designer, so that might have something to do with it.
Okay.
America Ferrera from Ugly Betty fame has just turned up as well, and she is looking gorgeous in this green floaty dress. It's kind of like a khaki number. I love her hair. That looks sensational. But waisted, she has a sensationally feminine figure.
I love the dress. Again, I love her. I don't mind the earrings. I don't think it matches with the overall look. I think it stands out too much. But otherwise, it's a gorgeous dress.
Pretty.
I love the clutch. And her jewellery is very simple.
The dresses are a little more than just eye candy, though. There's a bit of psychology to them, and it turns out if you want to win an Oscar, then you need to follow these rules. We did some research over the course of the weekend.
Okay.
No straps, no purple, and no Versace. Apparently, they're the rules if you don't want to win. And if you want to win, it looks like you need to wear white, because 25% of winners have been in that colour, 20% have been blue, 15% have been in gold, and just 5% in purple. You can see Penelope Cruz there, Meryl Streep, and Natalie Portman as well. And if you want to go home with a gong, you need to keep your shoulders covered. There's only been 8% of nominees who have gone for the strapless look, and they go on to win. Although one of the most recent, I guess, was Jennifer Lawrence in that gorgeous light pink strapless gown from Dior a couple of years ago. And the classic sleeve frock is always a winner as well. Most of the nominees keep covered in a classy sleeve frock. I guess that's the base of it. If you want to win, it's a classic, timeless look that people are going to look at photos in many years to come and say, oh, that was, you know, she did that well. You don't want to go too out there.
Exactly. Don't go too over the top. They obviously said purple's not going to win, so I'm not going to be winning an Oscar, but I'm not out for to win an Oscar, but definitely elegant, timeless thing that's going to look amazing in another 20 years' time. Don't go too over the top. We saw something before that was
I don't know what that was, but that was the worst thing I've ever seen. We'll talk about that later. And finally, though, designers matter as well. While Dior, Lanvin, Prada, Tadashi Shoji have all dressed four winners each, Versace, Elie Saab and Badgley Mishka always dress the losers, which is a little stuff. It's technical stuff, but we know those actresses will do anything to win. We're going to take a look at the red carpet because they're just starting to arrive, those big stars, and hopefully we'll have some terrific frocks to show you very shortly, Sarah.
Isn't that fascinating? I find that stuff really interesting.
I like I always like the Cher approach where you don't wear anything at all.
Yeah, Cher.